So I watched Spider-Man No Way Home and it was good. In fact, it's one of the best superhero movies ever. And with the end of that movie, MCU Spider-Man has a lot of potential to be the best live-action Spider-Man ever. It's already confirmed that we are getting movies 4, 5 and 6 with Tom as Peter in the MCU. So here's my pitch for MCU Spider-Man 4 Back to Basics. We see a piece of chalk writing on a brick wall counting down the days until he is out of jail. He is thinking about Spider-Man and how much he hates him. But then his cell door opens and we see a guard and he says, "You are free to go, Gargan." And he replies with, "Finally." Gargan, with a wicked smile on his face, runs off and leaves the building. He walks around New York City and is approached by two men in black outfits. And one of them offers Gargan a deal, that is, kill Spider-Man and get a sweet, sweet paycheck. Gargan smiles and then we get the new boring Marvel logo, which is not as cool as the old one. We then see Peter in the middle of his class and the bell rings. We see him leaving the room but is approached by Flash Thompson. Flash invites Peter to his party but Peter declines. We see that the people in his life have tried to reach out to him but he always says no. The lesson of this movie can be to let people back into his life, to not be selfish. We then cut to Peter in his apartment and his landlord says to him that he has not paid rent in over a week and that he smells like garbage, but Peter just ignores him. I loved the ending of No Way Home because it left Peter completely alone and he has absolutely nobody. We then see Gargan walking in a hallway and a shadowy hand was placed on his shoulder. He sees an absolute giant man but he is shadowy to us. The shadowy figure then tells him to come with him. They then enter a room with a rhino and a scorpion suit. The shadowy figure says to him, "Defeat Spider-Man with your teammate and get a big paycheck." Gargan replies, "Thank you so much." We then cut to Peter fighting some criminals. He is completely exhausted and he keeps thinking that how can there be this much crime in one city. The crime never stops and every day he keeps putting on the suit and fighting crime. He just keeps wishing that he had his old nanotech suits to do the job for him. But we see him trying to make his web wings so that he can glide in places which he cannot swing. We then see the symbiote on his window and it latches onto the floor and crawls under his bed. Peter gets a news report on some guy in a scorpion and rhino suit. Peter puts on his costume and swings to the scene. Scorpion and rhino try to kill Spidey while Peter just cracks jokes. Peter defeats them easily but they escape and Peter goes to his apartment and we see the symbiote latch onto his costume but Peter does not notice. He is not worried about them returning or anything but is wondering where they got the tech from. But he does not wonder about it too much and gets a call on his phone. The caller asks him where he is and that he late. Peter replies that be there in a moment, doc. And he puts on his costume and swings to the place. He enters the small apartment-like house and Peter says that he is sorry he is late. "Sorry, Otto." Otto replies, "It's okay, Peter. We are gonna have a Peter and Otto bond similar to the PS4 game." Peter is constantly worried about Otto becoming Dr. Octopus. We then see the shadowy figure reading a newspaper and he slams it on his table and screams pathetic. He then turns his chair around and we see Mac and Alexei, aka the Rhino. And Alexei says that he doesn't wanna do this anymore and he quits. I want Alexei to be the Sandman type villain because he does not really hate Spider-Man but is doing it for the money to afford food. The shadowy figure replies, "Well, that's okay, the exit is there," and he points to a metal door. Alexei walks to the door but then suddenly the room is filled with poison gas and the door shuts behind him. He pounds on it to let him out but then the pounds just disappear. And the shadowy figure says to Gargan that you don't want that to happen to you, right? Gargan replies terrified that if you give me one more chance I promise that the webhead will be dead. The shadowy figure replies that's the spirit but this time I am giving you an upgraded suit which has Tony Stark levels of engineering behind it. We cut to Peter swinging around New York City but he bumps into a woman in a cat costume. He asks her who she is and she replies with the black cat. Peter replies with, "Hey, aren't you the cat burglar?" She replies, "Yes, I am." Felicia is a little flirty with Peter but not too flirty. She recommends that her and Peter work together and they can find out why and who is doing all this but Peter declines because he is selfish in this movie. Felicia is a little bit upset and her and Peter part ways. We then cut to next morning and we see Peter wake up and look mad the time. It's 8:55 a.m. He's late for school. We see him do things in a hurry like eat breakfast and put on his clothes and costume and swing to the school. He tries to enter through the front door but it's locked. He decided to crawl through the vents. So he climbs to the top of the building and enters one of the vents. He breaks through one of them and lands on the floor. He busts open the door to his classroom and the teacher says that they have been wondering when Parker would arrive. Peter replies, I know I am late and I am so sorry. The teacher says, see me after class and take a seat now. And by the way, you wore your underwear above your pants. I want that joke in the movie to completely make Peter's life hell, because now all the students are gonna tease him about it. Peter looks at his underwear completely embarrassed and he takes a seat. After the class he goes to see his teacher. His teacher says to Peter that you are a good kid, Parker, and you have a bright future ahead of you, but why are you always late to class? This is the third or fourth time I am telling you, kid. This is your last chance, Parker. Now you have detention, so off you go. Peter goes to detention and sees a couple of his old classmates like Betty Brandt and Flash Thompson. But he then gets an alert on his phone saying that a couple of thugs are robbing a bank, and Peter has no choice and he leaves detention even though he's not supposed to. So he sneaks out of the building and suits up and swings to the place. He easily takes out the thugs and webs them up to a streetlight. He then decides to check up on Feast and how that's been going on. Once he enters the building he sees a young kid helping the people out. Peter goes up to him and asks why he is helping, to which the kid replies that it's the right thing to do. Peter smiles and asks the kid what's his name, and the kid replies Miles Morales. Peter decides to take the kid under his wing and gives him his phone number. Peter says that whenever you need any help with anything just call me. And Miles replies with thanks a lot, Pete. Peter leaves and climbs up to a rooftop and just lays down thinking about MJ, Ned, Tony May, and all the people who made his life happy, but now he has no one. Peter sighs, but then the black cat lands behind him and asks him, now do you want to work together? Peter replies, no. I will never work with you. And cat replies in a somewhat sad and angry voice, fine. Just don't come crawling back or whatever. And when Peter turned to look at Felicia, she was gone. Peter then walks to May's grave and starts talking to her about his day. But suddenly his spider sense starts going crazy. It has never gone this crazy before. And then the scorpion lands in front of him. Peter is a bit confused because he took down this guy no problem last time. Scorpion says that he has been stalking Peter for the last couple of days. And Peter is very weirded out by this, and Scorpion says that one hit of this tail would instantly kill you. Peter isn't that worried and they begin to fight. Peter doesn't have his web shooters but tries to fight Scorpion with brute strength and also by dodging his attacks. But then Peter loses focus for a second and he gets stabbed. Scorpion says goodnight Spidey and runs away. We then get a scene similar to the PS4 game of the River of Poison and Peter swinging and getting that phone call and those giant scorpion tails. Peter gets struck by one of them and we cut back to the real world and we see Peter just laying there completely lifeless as we cut to black. We see Mac jump through a window and says, I did it, I killed the webhead. The shadowy figure says, good work Gargan, and as promised here is your paycheck. Gargan says thank you and asks if he can keep the suit. The shadowy figure replies why not, and Mac leaves. We then see the symbiote from its perspective, similar to Spider-Man 3. But this time it crawls onto Peter's body, covering him from head to toe as we see Peter slowly regain consciousness. Peter wonders what this suit is and where it came from. But he doesn't focus on that because now he's on the hunt. So Peter finds Felicia and asks for her help, but she doesn't even talk to him. But Peter says that if she doesn't help him this city will crumble. And Felicia finally says yes, and the two of them decide that they need to work together. We then see Gargan on a rooftop trying to get the scorpion suit off him, but then Peter and Felicia land behind him. Scorpion turns to look at them and he's a bit surprised. And Peter asks him, have you missed me yet? Scorpion laughs and says to him that you really think a cat and a spider make a good team? Felicia says that oh, we will show you a good team, and the three of them start fighting. Scorpion is pretty easily defeated, but Peter starts to pound away at his face making the armor come right off him. And begins to start punching him over and over and over. He's about to make the final blow but Felicia stops him. And Peter backs away. Peter and Felicia then hand Gargan into the police and the day is saved. We then see the shadowy figure and one of his crooks come up to him and tell him that the webhead is still alive and Gargan lied. The shadowy figure replies no problem. His crook says that we have two more candidates, boss. The shadowy figure replies perfect. And we see a costume similar to the Green Goblin in a Taskmaster suit. We then see Felicia sitting on top of a building and Peter lands beside her. Peter takes off his mask and says, hi, I am Peter Parker, and Kat replies, Felicia Hardy. Peter and Felicia swing through the night sky together as the screen cuts to black. Similar to the Spectacular Spider-Man. Oh yeah, now for the credit scenes. The mid-credits scene of Peter swinging through the city and he lands on top of a building and enters the door. He walks down to the main office and says, "My name is Peter Parker and I am here to apply for the staff job." J. Jonah Jameson turns the chair and laughs and asks, "You serious?" Similar to Spider-Man 2. And now for the post-credits scene. It will be about Nick Fury and Maria Hill getting a signal on a couple of aliens breaking through. Fury and Hill are a little bit confused, but four aliens are coming into our world. And Fury says, "What the foo?" as the screen cuts to black. This scene is obviously setting up the Fantastic Four for the MCU. So MCU Spider-Man 4 has a lot of potential. It could be the greatest Spider-Man movie ever, or it could be The Rise of Skywalker Part 2. I am honestly really excited for the future of MCU Spider-Man, and with the end of No Way Home I have never been more excited for a movie ever. MCU Spider-Man 4 can make everyone love Spider-Man again. It has so much potential.